God is opening your eyes to take it. Take your job you have been searching for. Take your business you have been searching for. Take what you have been kind for. You have been searching for it. God is honoring you. I'm not dying there. I'm not dying in poverty. I'm not dying like. I'm not dying in stress. I'm reaching my destiny. There's a place I'm seeing where God is taking me. Can I prophesy somewhere? You are going somewhere. Are you seeing a place where other people cannot see? It's where God is taking you. People say, where is your God? This is the language of the heathen. You can see the language of the heathen. They question the ability of your God. Because they look at you as if you are failure. But I love this verse 13 that says, so 13, we thy people and sheep of thy pasture, we will give thee thanks forever. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So today I want us to talk about we are his sheep. You are God's sheep. You are. When God look at you, he say, my sheep. Are you hearing that? Tell your neighbor, say, you are the sheep. And there is pasture. If you understand that, you understand that you need to be close to God only.
So that
you get that pasture. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I've read many scriptures. I found truly, even in the last days, in Matthew 25, especially if you read it from 31
to 33,
he was talking about, you know, in the last days, the heathen and the Christians, when Jesus comes, will divide them. You'll be like a shepherd dividing them as a sheep and goats. You know very well that the sheep are not similar with goats. And therefore it means there is a clear difference between us and heathen. I'm sure you understand what I'm trying to say. If goats and sheep are not the same, and we are the sheep, and Jesus have to take us as a sheep, and himself as a shepherd, there have to be difference between us and them. Tell someone, my friend, there have to be a difference between you who follow Jesus and the one who doesn't follow Jesus. Because in 1 Peter 2:25, the Bible says we were led astray. But God took us as a sheep and we returned to him. Jesus, who is the shepherd, the bishop of our soul. What's the meaning of bishop? It's overseer. The man who sees and cares, he takes care. So we were astray like them, but we were taken back and we have returned to the bishop of our soul, who is our shepherd. Therefore it means we are not alone. We have someone who is always looking at us. But you know what is important is this pasture. I mean, always sheep, if they are inside and there's a gate close, The one who closed the gate knows the time to open the gate. I don't know if you're hearing me. So same applies to us if we are the sheep of our Lord. If we are not seeing anything, it means the one we are following is the one who closes it. It's not Satan. And he will be the one to open the gate. I don't know if you're hearing that. Jesus spoke that openly in John 11 and 10 from 11
John 10 to verse 11
to 16 he said
to 16
is different with the hireling. He was trying to prove that he is not there as a shepherd for a time being. And
he's
not doing it because he gets something.
He's
different with a hireling. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When he takes care of you, when danger comes, he's ready to die for that danger. Because of you. Jesus is saying, I'm not a hireling. I lowered down my life for the sheep. If you can read there, you realize that truly we have a shepherd. There. And he end up saying, a hireling, when it's tough, that hireling will save his life, he will run away and leave the sheep. They will be devoured. But the shepherd will stand there and defend the sheep. There are two things that you can learn there. Jesus says he is the defender. Number two, he leadeth you to a great pasture. He fight for you. Meaning that he protects you. But he also directs you where there's a great pasture. Can I tell you this? This is your life before God. Whoever fights you, fighting your defender. Whoever tried to block you is blocking the defender. Jesus is our shepherd. And also, so if there's any delay, don't mind. Because there's a direction where you are led for your pasture. Just so say, my friend, I don't want to worry again. There's a place where God is leading me, where I will never experience lack. Jesus is not a hireling. He's with us. Mind about us. I don't know if you are hearing me. Just as my friend, Jesus mind about you. Jesus is with you. And there's a pasture where he's taking you to. Don't mind about what you are facing now. He's your shepherd, bishop of your soul. When I said this, I was learning, how do you hear the voice of this shepherd? And I found that this shepherd said, one day he says, I am the word. I don't know if you're hearing me. And for us to visit the word, we become familiar with his voice. If you want to hear him speaking, believe his word. Take his word. The more you read, the more you stay in the word, is the more you become familiar with his voice. Because he said, my sheep here, hear my voice. In other words, you are called to come out from somewhere. You are not a sheep that will be in front of the shepherd. You are a sheep that follows the shepherd. And is the shepherd who called you to follow. But you need to know the voice. Otherwise, there are many voices. If the shepherd says, follow me, you will will follow. And you know he will leading you to great
pasture.
Sometimes you need to check. Whatever you are facing, the shepherd might be speaking something. Go back to the word of God and check what the word of God is saying concerning what you are facing. If the word of God says, yeah, you will face what you are facing, it's a temptation. Give glory to God. Because the shepherd is still in front of you. Listen to this. It's very bad to be in front of the shepherd. Also, it's very bad not to hear his voice. I don't know if you're hearing me. Many people today, they're the ones who are in front of the shepherd. Others, they are behind the shepherd, but when he speaks, they don't obey. God wants you to obey so that you become what he wants you to be. Tell us, my friend, I'm following my shepherd.